Do you have a car?
If yes,
click the subscribe button now.
Believe us,
sooner or later, you will need our help. We bet that you had to replace a burnt out headlight bulb at least one time in the past. Don't go to an expensive dealer for a simple bulb replacement. Subscribe to this channel and save time and money. Here you will find the best in the world information about halogen, xenon, and LED headlights. Based on more than 20 years experience, we will also show you how to troubleshoot and repair your headlights. Subscribe! Camera, action, lights!
Hi guys! Today I will show you how to troubleshoot and repair your Opel Vectra C and Signum xenon headlight in case of low beam failure. Please pay attention that this video is about the pre-facelift models produced between 2002 and 2005. I will deal with the more important technical side of the xenon headlight troubleshooting and repair, which requires specific type of knowledge. Mechanical side of the issue, that's to say removing the bumper and the headlight, is not the subject of this video. There are already a couple of videos at YouTube showing how to remove the bumper and subsequently the headlights from the car. Low beam troubleshooting and repair steps are same for both IFL type, adaptive type, Vectra C Signum xenon headlights and standard type xenon headlights. The only thing that you have to be careful is not to confuse the units located underneath the adaptive type xenon headlights. That's to say, don't confuse the ballast unit with the IFL adaptive type module. As you can see, the adaptive IFL type xenon headlight has two units underneath the headlight, but the standard type xenon headlight, which has a smaller projector, has only one unit underneath the headlight, and it's the ballast unit which powers the igniter and in turn the xenon bulb. The part number of the ballast unit is 5DV008290 middle line 00. This is the only thing that you have to be careful before beginning the troubleshooting of Vectra C xenon headlights. Before proceeding with the troubleshooting and repair steps, let me show you the Hella xenon system used at these headlights in action. If you don't have a low beam, basically one of these three parts is faulty. Either your ballast unit, your xenon igniter, or the D2S type xenon bulb is faulty. Let me show you all these three parts in action. As you can see, the ballast unit generates over 23,000 volts and sends this voltage to the xenon igniter. The xenon igniter transforms and reduces this high voltage to 85 and powers in turn the xenon bulb. As stated, if you don't have a low beam, basically one of these three parts is faulty. Now we can proceed with the low beam troubleshooting. The bad news is that in order to make a troubleshooting and eventual repair, you have to remove the whole headlight from the car, because the back cover of the xenon bulb is fixed to the headlight casing with three screws. And there is not enough space behind the headlight to work there. So in order to make the repair of or bulb replacement or the igniter replacement or the ballast replacement, you have to remove the entire headlight from the car. Otherwise you cannot do that. As stated before, there are a couple of videos in YouTube which shows how to remove the bumper from the Vectra C Signum models. Assuming that you already removed the headlight from the car, you should do a couple of swaps in order to identify the exact faulty part. In order to remove the headlight casing, you will need T15 Torx. I already removed the screws, left one, only one screw. So you have to remove the back cover, and then you will see the igniter placed. In order to make the troubleshooting, the first step that you have to do is the xenon bulb swap. In order to remove the xenon bulb, you just have to turn the igniter counterclockwise and pull it. As stated, the first step that you have to make is the xenon bulb swap. Assuming that this is the taken from the working side headlight, you should take the working xenon bulb out and you should replace, presumably, the non-working one. And basically, if you want to replace the xenon bulb, this is the way you, this is half what to do. As you can see, this is the D2S type xenon bulb. There is a notch on the top. You have to locate it to the projector, and you have to fasten the two springs located at each side, and then you have to place the igniter. Before placing the igniter, you should observe the openings and the alignment of the inner ring. If these openings are not aligned, then you will probably break the inner circle or the legs. And this is the igniter, and assuming that it's, and the vice versa, you have to turn it clockwise, quarter turn, and the plug is always put at the last stage. This is the bulb change. If you check, if you place the headlight to your car, and if you check the lights, and if you have a low beam, then you are lucky. You will need only the bulb. But if you don't, if you still do not have a low beam, it means that you have to proceed with the second swap. The second swap is the xenon igniter swap. The xenon igniter is Hella made 5DD008319 middle line 10. Basically, you can also use 5DD008319 middle line 50. They are both interchangeable. The only difference is that this one has a metal shield on top. If you remove this silver metal shield, you will see that underneath the metal shield there is the same igniter. Basically, you will have to take the working igniter from the working side headlight and put it to the presumably non-working headlight. After checking the alignments, you are pushing a bit further, and then at the last stage you are putting the xenon igniter plug. And now you have to check whether you have a low beam. And if you have a low beam, it means that you need a new igniter. But if you still do not have a low beam, it means that you have to check the ballast unit, which is located underneath the headlight. As stated before, 5DV008290 middle line 00. This is the Hella part number. If you Google it, you will see that this ballast unit is used at many makes and models. It's one of the most common ballast units used in the entire headlight industry. It's used in a Mercedes W211, BMW E60, Audi A6, A8, and etc. It's one of the most common ones, it's stated. That's all for the troubleshooting of the low beam failure at the Opel Vectra C and Signum headlights. If I have to summarize, if you don't have a low beam, basically one of these, as demonstrated before, basically one of these three parts is faulty. The D2S xenon bolt, the xenon igniter, or the xenon ballast. That's all for the troubleshooting. Please show respect to our work and subscribe to our channels. If you like our videos, we will be very happy as well. If you have any comments, just write down in the comment section, or if you have any questions, just ask. We will be happy to help you. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.